Hey, I'm Chris Wilmshurst, and today we're taking a look at the 14-port Thunderbolt 3 dock from OWC. They kindly sent this out to me to review, and it was a great excuse to clean up my desk. So I got to work disconnecting my CalDigit TS3 and replaced it with this. Now right off the bat, there isn't a huge difference between the two. The two obvious differences are the inclusion of a micro SD card reader, the lower and wider profile, a mini DisplayPort instead of a full-size one, and the omission of an extra USB-C port on the back. The OWC costs $249 on their website, and the TS3 cost me $230 from Amazon. Other than those differences, you have a UHS 2 SD card reader, 5 USB 3.0 ports, 2 Thunderbolt 3 ports, one which provides 85 watts of power, an Ethernet jack, optical audio out, a combi headphone jack, and a USB 3.1 Gen 2 port. Now I do like the design. It's clean, sits well on the desk, and it's not too imposing. But if I had to pick something I didn't like about it, it would be the glossy plastic top. It's a fingerprint magnet, and I'd have preferred it to be a metal or matte finish. One issue I had with the TS3 is that it got very hot quickly. I would pop out my SD cards and they'd be very warm to the touch. This doesn't eliminate all the heat, but it's far cooler in my opinion. The implementation of a USB 3 Gen 2 port on the front is great. If you have an NVMe external drive, you can take full advantage of it without having to plug it into the Thunderbolt 3 port behind. Also, be sure to check back later as I'll be reviewing this tiny waterproof NVMe drive from OWC. Make sure you subscribe. The 3.1 port gives you 10 GB transfer rate, which with my initial tests using an older NVMe drive, I was getting about 600 megabits write and 750 megabits read. To put that into context, it would take you a little over a minute to transfer 100 gig. The inclusion of a micro SD card is fantastic. If you work with drones or audio recorders, they all use them, so being able to just throw it straight in without one of these annoying adapters is welcome. Another bonus to this is unlike previous USB-C hubs I've used, you can use both SD card slots at the same time. Saving even more time as the UHS 2 slot is super fast. The 85 watt power delivery charges my MacBook Pro 16 inch really fast, and it doesn't lose any power draw when editing away for hours on end. The Ethernet port just works, but I'd love for it to be 10 gigabit, but I guess this is a cost saving exercise. I'm not a huge fan of mini DisplayPort, and having to buy new cables wasn't fun, but it does work with my gaming monitor, which requires a mini DisplayPort to HDMI cable. But there have been issues where the monitor hasn't woken up. And I did reach out to OWC about this problem with the waking up, and they said that it could be my cable. I don't have the issue when it's USB-C to HDMI, so they could be right here. However, if you don't want to use mini DisplayPort, you can always use the spare Thunderbolt cable if your monitor supports it. It's advertised to power two 4K displays or one 5K display. I have neither, so I can only test with my 144Hz 1080p monitor. Now we've gone over it, I really want to state how much I hate mini display port. It's a dated port that shouldn't be on this in my opinion. A full-size display port or HDMI would have been a much better inclusion, and it can be done. OWC offer it on the more expensive Pro Dock, but that dock is missing some of the many useful ports that come with this one. Another issue I have is Thunderbolt is a one cable solution, so the cable they include should at least be a meter. 50 centimeters is far too short for most setups, and I'd like to place my computer wherever I want without it being tied too closely to the dock. The price is also something I question. At $249, is it worth $10 more than a TS3? Is one less USB-C port and the addition of a micro SD card worth it? I'm finding it really hard to decide. I really like that it has a micro SD card reader and the clean look of it, but I hate mini DisplayPort with a passion. And is the combi jack better than two separate microphone and headphone jacks? If you use a headset with a TRRS connector, like Apple wired earphones, I'd say yes, but a lot of people use USB microphones now, so do we even need one? Especially as most people have a computer with a headphone and microphone jack already. I'm personally going to keep using it for a while, as it does speed up my workflow, and it looks great on my desk, but I won't be throwing out my TS3 just yet. So what do you think? Got any questions about it? Then please leave a comment below. consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.